Welcome once again. Now that we are done with the grade 10s, let's go to the grade 11s and try to look at electrical circuits. Okay, so what we are going to do is to try and see what is happening here. We have a problem. In the circuit diagram below, the battery has an EMF of 6 volts and a negligible internal resistance. Okay, so I'm going to try and draw the circuitry that is provided. I'm not very good with the drawing, but I'm going to try out my best. This is ammeter A2. This is another resistor. And this is what we have. And then this is 3 ohm. This is the voltage. Okay. This is 4 ohm. This is 2 ohm. I'm sorry. We're having A1 here. I'm very, very sorry. Having ammeter A1 there. They say EMF equals 6 volts. Okay. In the circuit diagram below, the battery has an EMF of 6 volts and a negligible internal resistance. Okay. So the first question says calculate the effective resistance in the circuit. So 7.1.1, the effective resistance in the circuit. Now, when you look into the circuit, wonderful people, we can try and simplify the circuit. Because I know that in a series circuit, the total resistance increases. The resistance in a series circuit increases. So I can redraw this, just this piece, as this. I can say 4 plus 2, it's 6. And then I have my 3 there, so I can have a parallel combination. So to calculate the effective resistance of the circuit, I can say 1 over R parallel equals 1 over 6 plus 1 over 3, because it's a parallel combination. And of course, this is 1 over R parallel will be equals to 1 plus 2, which is 3 over 6. 1 over R parallel, it's 1 half. Cross multiply 2 equals R parallel. So R parallel equals 2 ohm, which is the total resistance of the parallel combination. So R total, it's 2 ohm. I can do it in this way, or I can say, okay, if I don't want to do it in this way, I can say R series equals, just looking at the series 1, I can say 4 plus 2, which is 6 ohm. And I can therefore say, that's a 6, it's in parallel with this 3. Can you see that? So it's going to lead you exactly to this. Because you're going to say R total equals R parallel, and you know that 1 R parallel, it's exactly equals to this. You see, so it's the same. If you say R series, it's 4 plus 2 and it gives you 6, that 6 will be in parallel with this one, which leads you to exactly this. So you can't go sideways. This is the only route. All right. Now that we have the effective resistance of the circuit, which is the total resistance of the circuit itself, 2 ohm, where do we go now? They wanted the reading on ammeter A1. So the reading on ammeter A1. So I'm going to try and explain this. Now, let's say this is positive and this is negative. So current is moving in that direction. It gets in here, others passes to the side, they go. When they reach this point, it's a total current that goes into the battery. So A1 reads the total current. So I know that total current is equals to total voltage divided by total resistance based on Ohm's law. This is what we have. So total current is total voltage, which is the EMF of the battery, which is 6 volts. R total is equals to R parallel, because that's the total resistance of the circuit. In a parallel circuit, it decreases. You have 2, and that will give you 3 amperes. So that would be the reading on A1. A1 reads the total current that passes through the circuit, which is 3 amperes. They are looking for the reading on ammeter A2. Where is A2? A2 is situated between 4 and 2. But I know that the electron, the current that passes in this, is the same as the current that passes in this, because this is a series circuit. So A2 reads the current that passes in here, which is the same as the current that will go into that side. But in order to find the current that passes in here, I can just find the current that passes in here. Remember what we said when we simplified the circuitry here. We know that in a parallel combination, the voltage is the same. The voltage that passes here is the same as the voltage that passes in here. So I can find the current that passes in here, and then whatever amount that I find in here, subtract that from total, which is 3, and it will tell me the amount of current that passes here, which is the same as in that, because it's a series circuit. So I can say okay, let me try and do it in this way. Let me find the current that passes in this 3 ohm resistor. Okay, looking into this, so I can say the voltage that passes through the 3 ohm resistor will be equals to the current across the 3 ohm resistor multiplied by the resistance of the 3 ohm resistor. So how much of current passes through the 3 ohm resistor? I don't know that, but because this is a parallel combination, voltage is the same, which is 6 volts. So I can say 6 equals, I'm looking for the current. What is the resistance there? It's 3. So current that passes through the 3 ohm resistor would be 6 divided by 3, which will be 2 amperes. So I have 2 amperes in here. So meaning there's 1 ampere in both this and that. 1 plus 2 will give me a total of 3 that goes into this. Right, remember the question says the reading on ammeter A2. So I can therefore say, A2 equals 3 ampere minus 2 ampere, which is 1 ampere. There may be different ways of looking into this, but this is my approach. Very much my approach. Let's go to 7.1.4. They want the power dissipated by the 4 ohm resistor. So the power that is being dissipated on the 4 ohm resistor. I know that power equals voltage times current, but power is also equals to I squared times R. Okay, I know that in a series combination, voltage splits. So I'm not going to use this formula because I don't know the voltage that passes through this one. I only know the current. I'm going to use this one because I know the current in the 4 ohm resistor and I know the amount of resistance. So I'm going to say 1 squared times 4, which will give me 4 watts. Power in watts. Okay. And then I can go to 7.2. And they say, what is the reading on voltmeter V? No calculations are required. They want the reading on voltmeter V. Now remember, this has been simplified into this. Whatever that it reads on this would be the same as it reads in that, because in a parallel combination, voltage is the same. So V is 6 volts. Did they say motivate your answer? No, they just said what is the reading on voltmeter V? No calculation is required. So this is 6 volts because this is just for convenient purpose. V is 6 volts because this is a parallel combination. Whatsoever way you can put it. And then the last one in 7.3, they say this is worth 17 mark. A kettle is rated 1500 watts. Calculate how much a learner will pay for electricity for using the kettle for 4 hours. Eskom charges 1 kilowatt hour an amount of 2 rand 5 cents. Okay. Eskom charges 1 kilowatt hour electricity at 2 rand 5 cents. So what I can do here, they charge in terms of kilowatts hour. I have watts. I want to convert this to kilowatts. So I'm moving from watts to kilowatts. I'm moving from a smaller number to a bigger number. I divide from watt to kilo. It's 1000. So I'm going to take that 1500, divide that by 1000. This will be 15 over 10. I can divide by 5. This is 3 over 2. Okay. So this is kilowatts. So 1500 watts equals 3.5 kilowatts. I know that 1 kilowatt hour for 1 hour, 1 kilowatt for an hour, cost 2 rand 5 cents. Okay, but what is it that I have? I have 3.5 kilowatt, but I have 4 hours. How am I going to do this? How am I going to do this? 1 kilowatt hour, it's 2 rand 5 cents. So, I have 4 hours. So I'm going to say, three and a half kilowatt times 4 equals X. And I can say that my X is 3.5 times 4 times 2 rand 5 cents. Let's see if this will make any sense. Let's just try and check. Three and a half. I can multiply this by 4, and I can also multiply this by 2 rand 5 cents, and it would give me 12 rand 30 cents. I think this is making some sense. But we will try and check if this is true. 1 kilowatt an hour, it's 2 rand 50. I don't have 1 kilowatt, I have 3.5. I don't have 1 hour, I have 4 hours. That is equals to X. I think this is very, very correct. Highly and highly correct.